Christ did not have to offer himself many times. He wasn't like a high priest who goes into the most holy place each year to offer the blood of an animal. If he had offered himself every year, he would have suffered many times since the creation of the world. But instead, near the end of time, he offered himself once and for all, so that he could be a sacrifice that does away with sin. We die only once, and then we are judged. So Christ died only once to take away the sins of many people. But when he comes again, it will not be to take away sin. He will come to save everyone who is waiting for him. Those words come from Hebrews chapter 9, verses 25 to 28. Are you waiting for the return of Jesus? Do you get out of bed each morning thinking, this may be the day? Instead, I think that most Christians have a bucket list of things that they want to do before the Lord returns. When you are young, you want to experience growing up and getting married. Once you are married, you want to have children before the Lord returns. If your children are gone, you think about enjoying your retirement before the return of Jesus. How foolish to long for anything more than desiring the day when you will see Jesus face to face. There are signs of his return, and it clearly seems we are seeing some of those signs now. But the return of Jesus will come suddenly and without warning. Be ready for the return of Jesus today. And if he does not come today, then be ready tomorrow. Be ready for Jesus today and tomorrow and every day until he either comes or you go to be with him. Lord Jesus, help me to want nothing more than to see you face to face. May that day come soon. Praise you now and forever. Amen.